It's down to this. I've got to make this life make sense. Can anyone tell what I've done? I missed the life. Morning, guys. It's July 25th. We're in Shreveport, Louisiana. Getting ready to take off on the road. Our final stop for the day will be Pensacola, Florida. Pretty jazzed about the final location, but I'm not jazzed about the 460 miles on the road in the Louisiana, Alabama, and Mississippi heat. The cool thing about Alabama is I've never been to that state, ever, in any capacity. I've been to 48 states in our great union. Alabama and Wisconsin are the two I've never been, by way of motorcycle, by way of car, plane, nothing. So taking on Alabama today is going to be pretty cool. And then we have the morning ritual, that is packing the bags. It's kind of a pain in the butt, and it's one of my least favorite things to do, but you know, it's a part of the business we're in. One thing I didn't show you last night that I should have was my speeding ticket. I got pulled over last night about 10:30 at night, and I'm not saying I had forgotten that Texas drops your speed limit by 5 miles an hour after dark. I just kind of ignored it. Fortunately for me, the officer that pulled me over was so used to sport bikes running from him, and just on the mere fact that I pulled over in a timely and efficient manner, proceeded to give me a warning only. So I'm pretty thankful for that. The maid just came by to tidy up my room. I opened the door, not realizing I had a camera here on a tripod, so I'm sure she thought I was making autoerotic porn. What I'm doing now is making my hotel reservations for Pensacola. Forgot where I was going. One thing about motorcycling cross country is that it's a romantic notion. You know, it kind of reminds you of the old West, I guess, you know, out alone on your steed. But I get criticized a little bit for staying in a halfway decent hotel, using the internet to make my hotel reservations and not camping and stuff. And it does take a bit of the romance out of it, but I like to use my knowledge of technology to my advantage. And the reason for this is that I'm in the military, and I'm pretty used to roughing it or being in situations that aren't quite civilized. And so this is my time, my vacation, and I want it to be kind of nice. So here I am with my laptop making my hotel reservation. I've got my fancy camera, my iPhone, my GPS, whatever. So anyway, I'm gonna knock this out. I'm gonna pack up some more and get on the road. Well, guys, I am in, let me look at the camera here. I'm right outside of Monroe, Louisiana. I stopped for a second because the sky opened up and it looked like it was gonna rain. I was gonna get my rain gear on, but to be honest, in this heat, I kinda wanna get wet. So I'm actually not gonna put my rain gear on, but I'm gonna zip up my cameras and whatnot, keep those protected. I don't know if you can see the sweat stripping off my face. It's 97 degrees, but more so, it's incredibly humid, and it's killing me. So we're pressing on, and we're making a movie. I just rode by Gibby something, Louisiana. Wanted to stop there. I don't really have time today to do any sightseeing stuff. Today is still a mission essential mileage day. But that particular location is where Bonnie and Clyde were ambushed back in the 30s, and I thought it'd be kind of cool to actually stop at the road that they got shot up at, but unfortunately we don't have time for that. But I did see the sign for the town.
That's about it for now. I'll catch up with you in a bit.
Hey guys, it's Billy here. It is a little after 3 o'clock. I just wanted to bring you around here. We just crossed over Mississippi River, and we are in Mississippi. I don't know if I can get that on the camera there.
I gotta say, this is definitely some of the most difficult videotaping I've ever done, trying to do this solo. This is actually the Welcome Center that I'm at, and I thought I would pull in here because I saw that they had a sign, but later on, if we actually see one on the side of the highway, we'll get in.
Good evening. We're in Pensacola, Florida now. We're about 900 miles into the trip. I'm tired, my butt hurts. We didn't get the Alabama or the Florida state sign today because both of them were on a bridge, neither one of them had a pull out. So tomorrow we're gonna try to go find a back road. I'm gonna actually grab the map here in a second. Find a back road and find both those signs and do a little loop back, and so we can knock those out. Today itself was not a bad ride. It was hot, muggy, sticky, but other than that, it was good. We did have the electrical gremlins that plagued us during Byway Motorcycle 3 reared their ugly head in some small podunky gas station in Alabama. I push started on my own. I found a hill and was able to push start it myself. So lucky there, and I rode in here. I started in the parking lot just fine, so I don't know if that was maybe a fluke or if that's a sign of problems yet to come, but tomorrow we're going to try to get to Birmingham, Alabama. We're going to get those two state signs first. And we're going to get to Birmingham, and we're going to see the Barber's Museum. So I'm just going to sit here and rest for a bit. I may get back with you, do a little reflection on the trip. What are the big differences I've noticed between riding this ride with Tracy and riding it by myself is we don't stop at restaurants and eat as much. I didn't even eat all day today. I just stopped at a gas station, got a snack, and just now when I came in, I walked down to a burger joint and ate. And it's not that Tracy loves to stop and eat either. It's just, I've noticed that you want to stop and eat at a nice restaurant because it's social time. You know, because when you're actually on the bike, you're almost like you're by yourself anyway, because you're just, if you're in the lead, all you're doing is checking your mirror for the other bike. And if you're behind, you just kind of check up on the bike, but you're really all by yourself. And stopping and eating is when you actually get a chance to kind of reflect and talk about the ride. You know, did you see this? Did you see that? Or I noticed this. And I think that's why we stop and eat, where today I didn't stop at all. I ate at gas stations, a candy bar here, a piece of beef jerky there, but I totally forgot to eat. I was so determined to get here. So kind of an interesting piece that I noticed that is part of the ride.